rest of the commission will consent to it. I understand that the authority met today, and if it's okay with the rest of the board, could you give us a report on it?
Well, the authority slash trustee committee.
Well, let me make sure everybody's in agreement.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, sir.
It's fine, all means.
Met today, and there was a couple of what I would call important decisions that were made by the board. One of those decisions, and there was quite a lengthy discussion on this, and I really don't know why, but in the RFP process, we met from 12:30 really till approximately 4:00. Most of it was closed session meeting, but in public session, the board voted that they would be the ones to approve the RFP process before the RFPs go out. We have those as presented by the consultants in Florida. You will be getting those shortly. They may be forwarded to Paul. I'm not just sure what the distribution method will be. It's about 100 pages, and we had negotiated with the board that county commissioners would have an opportunity to look at those RFPs and to comment on them. So when you get those, you need to look at it. Whatever changes you want to make, whatever ideas you have, you need to immediately call Paul. It's probably better to take them through Paul than it would be the hospital board, because they're without a CEO at the moment. And we're going to meet on, I believe it's Tuesday night, the 13th. It could be the 14th, but I believe it's the 13th. We're going to meet to hear comments from the doctors. We had also agreed that the doctors and the hospital medical staff would be allowed to comment on the RFP and to make suggestions as far as items that they wanted included in that. Now, you must reduce your changes to writing and show a page number, or if it's not included as a page number in there at all, give just a brief description. And the reason for that is the board is anxious that we get these in the hands of the 13 people, the 13 institutions, public and private, one of them private, the other 12 public, as soon as possible so that they can begin work on those. And if we go to the meeting on the 13th, and it's not a negotiating type meeting. In other words, when you walk in, you need to have a pretty firm idea about what you want to do, because we're going to aggregate these ideas, those that we approve of, into the good ideas is the best way to put it, I guess, into the document. The document's going to go out within a few days. So that's where we are on those. The debate that went on the board and the vote that was taken publicly was as to whether the executive committee would approve the future of the RFP process and whatever offers we got and that sort of thing. And we voted 7-1 that the full board would do that. Now, I advocated for the full board, but I voted against the process. I was a single lone no vote. And the reason that I was a no vote was because the word sale of the hospital was in there. The attorney did a good job of explaining why sale had to be in there, because the general statute said if you think you might want to do this, you need to put it in there. And so they argued for it to be in there. I wanted it taken out, but the commissioners were, the hospital commissioners were interested in things going forward. So the vote was 7-1. To proceed with this, and mine was a procedural vote because my board here had told me they weren't interested in selling the hospital, and I didn't feel like that I should be on record insofar as protecting commissioners with voting to sell the hospital. So that's where we are on that issue. Now, the more important thing that took place was that the chairman of the board, Sandy Hardy, put on the floor table that University Health Systems is to take over the management of Beaufort County Hospital tomorrow morning under an arrangement that we do not have in writing and do not know the terms of. Four of us fought that as hard as we could. Alice Mills Sadler, Clifton Gray, and Alan Robertson and Hood Richardson voted against that item simply because we didn't have the details of it, and we did not think that it was in the best interest of the future of the hospital. The vote was 5-4. Yes?
Right there, could I'd like to ask you a question. According to the newspaper,
one of the nonprofits backed out of the process, which I think was New Hanover. Another one was the one that's gonna manage it in the morning?
Yeah, we only have one nonprofit, and that's the one that...
That's the one that's gonna manage it in the morning?
Yes, Sandy Hardy has talked with them and brought in some quotes from the CEO of that hospital, and that everything was gonna be fine and great.
Well, is that a conflict?
The issue was raised, was conflict was raised. It was debated back and forth heavily and strongly. The hospital's attorney rendered the opinion that he didn't think it would be a conflict, that it could be couched so that it wasn't a conflict. There was a lot of disagreement on that particular issue, and the vote still went down 5-4. What you need to understand about this, if they take, they have a crisis management group is who is going to be doing this from University Health Systems. And apparently this group served them well in the past in acquiring hospitals. But it's disappointing to me that this happened, because it means that the dual process is dead, because you're bringing in new management that has no familiarity with this. There has been no provision made to educate that management in the dual process or what is going on. It's going to be simply a management thing. They're going to manage it with our money. We didn't have any money to begin with. Some people seem to think they're going to show up with money. I can assure you they're not going to show up with money. And to our surprise, after the vote was taken at 5-4, the chairman of the board announced that they would be here tomorrow morning to take over the hospital. So this, to me, is, I'm still weaving under this, because we had the meeting, as I say, lasted almost 3.5 hours, and there was a most of it was closed session, and we hammered and hammered and hammered, and their mind was made up as to how they wanted to proceed with this. So the dual process among the majority, one statement you made.
Okay.
The dual process, while it was agreed to get the RFP process started to appease guys like me who wanted to try to save the hospital, the five people on the hospital board have never, or let's say the board, had to institute efficiencies or to cut expenses or to match labor to business so that we could try to make this thing save itself. So, but I think at the moment, that's dead. Yes?
I assume they're going to charge a fee, University Health Systems.
We don't know what that fee is.
So we're entering into a contract. I mean, the hospital's entering into a contract with no understanding whatsoever what the cost is going to be.
That is correct.
I'm incredulous just to know that.
May I ask a question?
Hold on. Who's in charge?
No.
You were in charge.
He means of this meeting.
Yeah, okay.
Now you may go.
My turn. Okay. Let me see that if I understand this. Suppose that the hospital makes a profit, that in a quarter while this is going on, that profit stays at Beaufort County Hospital?
Yes.